Hello, hello, hello. Can everybody hear me? Let me hide this. I know I said 8:30, we still got 2 minutes to 8:30. Say hello to everyone. Hey, what's going on? What's going on? I know it's late evening. Well, it's late for me. It's about to be 8:30 in the evening. All right. So today is going to be IPv4 subnetting, summarization, and VLSM. Okay. But I'm going to show you is the way that I do it. All right. You can't go wrong the way that I do it. It is the fastest way out there to subnet, to do anything. Is taking everything to binary, all right? So then, hey, what's up, Parth? Sam, what's up? How you doing? Good to see you here, my friend. Good to see you here. All right. So this is gonna be it's gonna be fun. It's only an hour. It's not bad. We may go a little bit over. I usually do. All right. And this is on StreamYard. Okay. This is on StreamYard, not Zoom. So I got my screen that's shared here to the left. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put this first. Let me write some stuff in there first. So, I'll just show you. Let me just show you that right now. All right. So, what's gonna happen? This is the way that I submit. When I look at an IP address at a problem, whether it be a network plus, whether it be a CCNA, whether it be CCNP, any networking exam that you're gonna take, anything that you're gonna do. Real world or certification world, all I look at is a mask. CIDR 20, let's say CIDR 28, okay? A CIDR 28. We know that IPv4 address, you got 32 bits, 4 octets in each one. I look at this and I do this. 8 bits on, 8 bits on, 8 bits on, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fine, 1, 2, 3, 4. That right there, and I'll put my face in there so you can see my expression, okay? This line right here tells me everything I would need to know. Wow, that's kind of big. I'm gonna put myself a little smaller. There you go. That line right there tells me everything I need to know. That line right there is telling me that I increment by 16, right? This bit value right here, that's 16. So if my network increments by 16, if I add all these up, it's 15. Do I really add all these up? No, it's one less 16 is 15. That helps me calculate broadcast and also tells me the walkup mask. Let me show you what I mean. We all know the bit values, 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. All right, I expect you guys to give me questions as well, okay? All right, so this bit value right here, these are your bit values per octet. So this is 16. 1 less 16 is 15. So I just put it right there. That's 15. If you were to add these bit values, okay? If you were to add these guys right there, that's 15. Why add? It's always one less the bit value. It will always work out that way. No matter where your line is at, it will always be one less that network increment because that's what that 16 is. All right, so I got my bit values. When I count for host, this is a question that everyone has asked me constantly. All right, Laz, why do you count by two? Isn't the formula 2 to the n minus 2? So I just start by 2 and double as I go. 2, 4, 8, 16. 16 minus 2 is 14. Same thing for host. I'm going to count from here, 2, 4, 8, 16. I got 16 subnets. I got 14 hosts. Here's my wildcard mask. I just do 0, 0, 0, and then I got 15. There's your wildcard mask right there. So doing this line is going to give you the answers to every last thing out there. Doing it this way. All right. I did a video on YouTube earlier. But so we won't do that one. But I am going to open up this old CCNA book that I have. Let me see where it's at. Right there. All right. This is from the 64802, I think it was, or the 120. I think it's from the 120 exam. And look, perfect. It opened up just to that. So we're going to work on this right here. We're going to work on this. Let me maximize this so you guys can see it. And I want you to write your questions. What's up, Juan? What's up? What's up? Okay, I want you to ask your question. We're going to start from the very first one, okay? And my notepad, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it down here. All right, and we'll work it out together. Let me minimize this. And I need you guys to give me answers. I need you guys to give me answers, give me questions, what you don't understand. So I'll do the first one, okay? So in this one, it's saying, but what is the maximum number of IP addresses that can be assigned to a host on a local subnet that uses that particular mask? When they give me a mask, I don't pay attention to nothing else. It gave me, this is the mask it gave me, 255.255.255.224. Perfect. What do I do? I do x dot x dot x, 1, 2, 3. Line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, some of you are saying, maybe, that, hey, Lance, how do you know it was three lines? Because I know my bit to decimal table. 128, 64, 32, 16, 84, 21. So my line is right here. I know that if I add these three right here, that's 224. One bit, 128. Two bits, 192. Three bits, meaning on, 224. Four bits, 240. Five bits, 248. Six bits, 252. Seven bits, 254. And eight bits, 255. You need to know this off the top of your head. Okay, so I draw the line right there. So what are they asking me? They're asking me, what is the maximum number of IP addresses that can be assigned to a host? Okay, so I'm looking for host addresses, right? So I start from right to left. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Right, so I got 32 host addresses minus 2. Why minus 2? Because I subtract the network and the host. Equals 30. There's your answer. The answer is B. This right here, stop with the high order bits, the low order bits, the 2 to the whatever, minus this and all that nonsense. You don't have a calculator when you go take this test. You got to be able to look at an address and based on the mask, know what it is they're giving you. When you take a test, okay, they're not going to give you the full thing. They may just give you the last octet and a mask. That's it. You need to figure out what's what. I'm telling you this right now. You need to know this. After a while, you've done enough, you'll remember. Yes, Sam put it there. Let me show you what Sam put up there. He put that right there. After you've done for a while, you'll remember 128, 192, 224. Exactly. Practice makes perfect. RTR. Okay? So now, that's just straight out just counting for hosts. But we want to be able to subnet. So let's go down. Let me click in here. So let's not even do that one. Let's do an actual subnetting question. Okay, right here. What is the subnetwork address for the host with an IP address of 210.5.68 with a 28? And let me tell you right now, Cisco loves to increment by 16. They love it. They love it with a passion, right? Some CIDRs you need to pay attention to is 12, CIDR 12, CIDR 20, and CIDR 28. They all increment by 16, okay? They all increment by 16. So what does that mean? You better know the incrementation of 16, but I'll tell you that later. All right, so we got this question. So what subnetwork does that IP address belong to? All right, so you look at the mask, 28. Okay, so that's I do again my little thing, x dot x dot 1, 2, 3, 4, line 1, 2, 3, 4. But I mean, I already know, but I'm just showing you a visual. But this right here is 16. So I got to increment by 16 to get close to 68. 16, I'll do it here. So this will be your net ID, right? So you got 16. 32, 48, 64, and then 80. Juan C. said, I used to know this by heart. Thinking about pursuing my CCNA, I will be a frequent viewer. Awesome. Okay. 16, 32, 48, 64, 80. Well, 80 is too big for 68. So it's got to be somewhere in here, right? So it looks like it's the answer is 64. Let's calculate it. Let's find out the broadcast. This is the network ID. Let's find out the broadcast. Okay, so what's 1 less 16? That's that bit value right here, right? If you add all these up, what did I say you get? 15, right? Well, what's 15 plus 64? 15 on the last octet plus this network right here, that's 79, right? So that's really x at x, that's 79. What's in between? Well, what's after 64? 65. What's before 79? 78. So does 68 fall in this range? It sure does. So now your answer is C. Your answer is C. Let me get my notepad back up here. 64. But if you know already that you were going to increment by 64, because when I look at 28, I know I'm incrementing by 16. And in my head, I'm going 16, 32, 48, 64. I know the incrementation of 16 already. And this is something that I tell everybody that goes takes their Network Plus and go takes their CCNA. Write down the incrementation of 16. Because if you write that down all the way, because it goes from 0 all the way to 240, incrementing by 16. Once you get that, those are your network IDs. You can then calculate whatever you want at that point. Okay? So that will be the answer. Again, you got to learn this. This is how I do that. This is how I do that. We're going to do one more question from here, and then I'm going to go to submittingquestions.com. Let me see. Let me pick a good one. Here's a good one. This is awesome, because the first time I saw this question many moons ago, I was like, what? What do you mean describe it? I have no idea what they're talking about. All right? So, and a lot of the times, believe it, it's the way they phrase the question is that what gets you confused in answering in the test. So they're saying, which statement describes this IP address? All right, so they're giving me 10.1.3.65/23. Now, when they give you the CIDR, that's awesome. When they give you the CIDR, that means you're good. You know exactly where to draw your line, right? 23 bits in, because that's what that means. So I'm going to go 8 and 8, 16 and 8. Oh, that's 24, sorry. So you go 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, line 0. That's 24. That's 24 or 8 bits there. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Awesome. This bit value is 2. 1, 2. That's the bit value. All right. I'm not counting for networks or counting for hosts. The bit value. All right. So this is equal to this. Awesome. They want me to describe it. Listen, I have no idea what that means. Okay. What do you mean describe it? I have no idea. So I'm going to work it out. Network. The network ID. What's the network ID? I usually start from zero here. I'm not. I'm just going to start by the increment. So I'm going to go 10.16.2.0. That's my network. Because this is 2. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. It increments. So I just started by the increment, 2.0. All right, let's figure out the broadcast. All right, well, everything to the right of the line. This bit value here is 1. All these add up to 255. Awesome. Let's find the broadcast. Cool. We got 10.16 dot what? 1 in the third octet plus 2 is 3. And 255 in the last octet and 0 is 255. Well, there's your broadcast. What's in between? That is your range. Let's write that out there. Okay. I'll line it up in a bit. This will be 2.1. That's after 2.0. And what's before 3.255? 3.254. Now let's make it look pretty. Oh, we already did. There you go. So now it says describe that. What do they mean? Okay, let's go up here. So a little bit higher. There we go. It says the subnet address of this particular network that they're stating is 3.0. No, it isn't. It's 2.0. So that's wrong. The lowest host address is 2.1. That's true. There it is right here. So this is, B is one of the answers, 2.1. The last valid host address is 2.254. No, it's 3.254. the broadcast address of the subnet address is 3.255. That's true. It's 3.255. So D is normal. So B and D. And then E is just nonsense. E is just nonsense. You see how that worked out? All I did is that I took this IP that they gave me with that mask. I drew my little thing here. Okay. I put in the bit values. There's the sum of all these bit values. And I was able to calculate. I could have done zero, but I didn't. I said two. And besides, I know it was three. So I know it would have been zero anyway because I increment by two. So that's why I started by two. But that's what they mean. Work it out. It's just a couple seconds. It's no big deal. This is the way you got to do things because this is going to give you the answers to whatever question they're going to give, they're going to ask you. I mean, look, let's maximize this. Let's maximize it. Again, this is your wild card. There's two ways of doing it, but I just use this. I put 00, 1.255. That's my wild card mask. And this number is also used to calculate for broadcast. That's it. How many hosts? Well, if I start by two hosts, and let me write this down for you. When you count for host, is from right to left. Okay? And when you count for subnets, is from left to right. And you start by two and double as you go. Start by two and double as you go. So you got, I'm going to count for hosts. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, minus 2, 510. So here we got, let's write the host down. Host. We got 510. Okay, somebody's got a question. Hey, what's up, Trinidad? When taking the exam, is a pencil and paper allowed? When you go take the exam, do not take anything with you besides your IDs, okay? Your driver's license, passport, that letter you get from Cisco or Pearson View that says you have an appointment just for verification because they should have you in the computer. Get there 30, 45 minutes before. I get there an hour before, all right, to make sure everything is good to go. Do not take your own pencil and paper. Do not walk in to that testing center where the little area is at. Do not take anything in. Everything will be put in a locker. Your wallet, your phone, your watch. Everything will be your keys. Don't take anything in there but yourself. You will sign in. They will provide you either with pencil or paper or a laminate and a grease pencil. That's it. Don't take anything in there. They won't allow that. You're not allowed calculators. You're not allowed anything. If they think you're cheating, you're going to get messed up. I personally, when I went to take my CCIE written in South Florida, I think it was 2014. All right. There was an individual, as me and the proctor were walking in, pulled out a piece of paper. I think it was his notes he had taken earlier. They stopped the test. You got to be very careful. You're welcome. You're welcome, Juan. All right. You got to be very careful. So yeah, there, do not take anything in. Go comfortable. All right, go early and be ready. Be ready. All right. Okay, so 510 hosts. How many subnets? I'm going to start now. What I showed you earlier, let me pause here. What I showed you earlier, I started counting from here. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. 128 networks. That will be the wrong answer. Why? Look at the class of address this is. It's an A. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That really, this line can be moved all the way up to its class full boundary. Okay, let me put my face in here once again. Like, oh, full face. I scared everybody. All right. Class full boundaries. That's important. In submittingquestions.com, All right. They're going to do that. They're going to put a class B. They're going to put a class A. And they'll use a CIDR 23 or CIDR 28. You're going to count those 16 hosts or whatever the case may be. But those networks, you got to go all the way back to the class full boundary. Now, in your, I haven't seen a cert yet. And I've been around since the 640.801. I haven't seen a cert yet that makes you count anything over 65,536. Okay, I haven't seen that yet. So as long as you know the first two octets or the third and the fourth octet, how many hosts are in there, you're safe. They're not going to make you count more than two octets. That's just, that would be just not nice. Okay, so definitely you got to know what's going on. Give me a second. And remember, you only have 1.5 minutes per question average on CCNA. So learning the last way is the best. Thank you, sir. Just my opinion. I appreciate that. That is true. That's why I need you to get down when you start doing this stuff down to 30 seconds or less. And not everybody claims that. Everybody on YouTube, oh, 30 seconds or less, 30 seconds or less, 30 seconds or less. I need you to do this in 3 seconds. I need you to be able to look at something and say, that's the answer. Do you not have 10 fingers? You can subtract two right here. Okay. I mean, count for hosts. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. What? Same thing. Okay. So you need to be quick. You need to be quick when it comes to this. All right. You need to be quick. All right. And networks. So now let's count for networks. It's a lot of networks. All right. So two. So we know it's 256 right there. Here we go. 512, 1024, 2048, 4096, 8192, 16384. No, I screwed up. This is 256, 512, 1024, 2048, 4096, 8192. No, 16384, 32 something, and then six, I forgot. Then 65,536. I forgot this one. It's been a while. But I memorized. I wasn't adding. I memorized these two. Right now I forgot it, but that's fine. I memorized the counting by two up to there. I memorized it. I memorized the incrementation of 16. Why? Because, let me show you. Let me reduce the font size because I have it pretty big. Let me see. Let me maximize this. I want to see what you guys tell me if you can see this okay. All right. I want to reduce the font size here. I'm going to reduce it to a 24. Can you see that okay? Can everybody give me a thumbs up or something? Let me know that you can see this. All right. Because I'm gonna increment by 16. I need space. Okay. I'm going to start from zero. 16, 32, 48. All right, cool. 48, thanks, Clydesdale. Oh, Clyde. Hey, Clyde. 48, six, okay, I lost count. 0, 16, 32, 32, 48, 64, 80. Saying one thing, running another. 80, 96, 112, 16, 128, 192, 208. 224. I think I'm missing something here. 240. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, I'm missing something. Yeah, of course I'm missing something. 144. And then we got 16, 160. Yeah, I was just in a hurry. And one, look at that. I'm missing a whole bunch of 16. And 16 is 176. There we go. Now we're cooking. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. There you go. That's the incrementation of 16 right there. Okay? That's the incrementation. That is what you need to know automatically. Why? Why do you need to know that? Imagine they give you a question. You have the following. The following. Let me put it in caps. The following IP address, 192.168.1. Let's give it 201. All right. And they gave you 255.255.255.240. Well, you do your little thing that I just showed you, little diagram, x.x.x.1234, line 1234. You're like, my God, that's 16. I got to go all the way in the last octave to 200. Well, if you have this already, you're saying 201 is not here. 201 is here. Right? This is 208. So 201 has to be here. And check this out. These are your network increments. Check this out. Right? That's your network increment. Or your net ID. Let's put it that way. Your net ID. Your network increment is 16. Okay? That's your net ID right here. 201. 201 is right here. Okay? So how do we calculate that? Remember I showed you? You got 15 plus 192 and all that good stuff. Well, why don't you just say even easier? What's 1 less 208? 207 in the last octet. So what's in between 193 through 206? That's it. So before the test starts, where you're taking all these little silly things, you're answering how to take the test, that's all you do. It's done. I got to slide out now, Master Chief. Just wanted to stop by. I appreciate you stopping by, Sam. I appreciate that, bro. Much love, brother. Keep educating. It's the right way. Be easy. Be safe. I'll talk to you later. You got it, man. All right. So that's all there's to that. That's all there's to that. This has been a lifesaver. That right there. Now, this is a good idea if you have the time and you remember and you memorize the heck out of this. Okay. Write it down. Write it down. You're going to need it. You don't have time to do math. You do not have time to do math in the test. I need you to be able to do this. I'll say 10 seconds, not 3 seconds. That's a little bit much. All right. I'll say 10 seconds. All right. 10 seconds. Get this done. Why? Because you need when they ask you more complex questions as such. I'm going to give you a NAT configuration. Okay. Where am I? Okay. So I'll go IP NAT pool LAS. I'll say it's a public IP address 1.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1. Net mask 255.255.255.0. I'm just making it easy. I'll make it for you guys. And then access list 1 permit 192.168.1.0. Now you're supposed to allow 200 people. Okay. So you got to make sure that you allow 200 people. Okay. And then IP NAT pool. No, I'm sorry. IP NAT inside source. So source list 1. Pool labs, remember, case sensitive, and the magical word overload. What's the problem with that right there? What's the problem with that right there? And we're talking about subnetting. We're talking about wall card masking. What's the problem right there? Oh. The problem right there is this guy. Nobody's answering. All right. The problem right there is this. I'm only allowing what this network. No, that's not, you don't do that. All right. 255. That's what you need to put. And that's how they're going to trick you. Okay. You need to understand wildcard masking. You need to be able to configure wildcard masking. Okay. So if they give you 15, how many hosts do you have? 14. 15 is 1 less 16. That means you have a 240, correct? In the last octet, since we're working in the last octet. So that if you count from left to right, that's 4 bits, right? And here, let me get them back in the picture. That's 4 bits that are on, right? 2, 4, 8, 16, -2, 14. But you need to allow 200 people, not enough. This is where the issues come in this. And this is why this is so important. Let me show you again the book. Let me see where the book is, right here. Let me show you some subnetting questions that are not straightforward subnetting questions, but are actually ACLs, hidden in an ACL. Review questions. All right, let me close this. There you go. No, not that, not that, not that. Is it this one? Yeah, right here. Who can give me the answer to this one? Let me put it full screen so you guys can see it. You need to create an access list that will prevent host in the network range 160.0 to 181.0. Which of the following lists would you use? I need a letter answer. I'll give you 30 seconds. I need a letter answer. It's number two, this guy right here. Give me an answer. From 160.0 to 191.0. What would be the answer? Come on. Quickly, quickly. Very good, Claude. Very good. The answer is C, right? All you got to do is take that 31, add it to the 160, and you got it. And you got it. That's it. 191. It can't be 31 plus 0 because it's 31. You need 191. That's all you had to do. But I can hear the wheels turning, okay? Well, I got the mask and the host and the this and the override and the high bit and the low bit. Forget all that. Forget all that. You don't need that. Let's go to another one. Very good, Claude. And these are access lists. There you go. You want to create a standard ACL. I'm right here, number 10. You want to create a standard AC access list that denies the subnet from the following host. 172.16.50.172/20. Which of the following would you start your list? Now, I'll give you a clue. One of the things that you need to look at is what's always the same. Access is 10, deny. It's the same all the way down, so that can't be wrong. So you need to be paying attention to the back part of the syntax. All right, it's a subnetting question. So what will be the answer in this case? Come on, I need a letter answer. D. No, not. Oh, 16. He is correct. 16. Why? Because 20, let me bring up my notepad. 20, let me minimize this. You can see the question as well. So you have the CIDR 20. What is CIDR? Ooh, that's 21. CIDR 20, what does that mean? X dot X dot that's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, line 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 16, what's one less 16? 15. That's the only one with 15. Done. That's the answer right there. This little line will tell you everything. And the more you do this, the more you do this, and you do it this way, it's going to become second nature to you, like your timetable, like you're adding 2 plus 2, because that's all you're really doing. Okay? Very easy to do. Very easy to do. Let's go to submittingquestions.com. All right. Here's our first question. Again, look what they're asking you. 23. All right? So the address is 172.20.236.202/23. So what network does that belong to? Well, what do? I do the same thing that I always do. XX 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, line 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. What's our increment? 2. Oh my God. You mean to tell me I got to increment by 2 to get to 202? I'm not going to do that. I can't 2, 4. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that. What am I going to do? I'm going to do, what number can I multiply by 2 that gets me close to 202? 101. Right? 101. If I take 101 times 2, what does that equal? Well, 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 1 is 2. It's 202. Oh, okay. So That is, oh, I'm in the wrong octet. I'm looking at 202.1, I should be looking at 236. I'm still incrementing by two. So 236 is, it's even, right? It's an even number. So that can go into, well, you can divide two, that's 13, that's one. So I can divide two into 236 and it's gonna come out evenly, right? Because two goes into two ones, two goes into three ones, that is 16, that's 18, that's 118. So the network ID, I divided. That's all I did. I divided. I know my incrementation. I'm not going to increment two at a time. I'm just going to divide. Or you can multiply, whatever you like, whatever is easier for you. But the network is 172. And if I'm wrong, please tell me so. If my math is wrong, tell me. Correct me now. Okay? Broadcast. Okay? And you do the same scenario. And we'll find out sooner or later if I'm wrong, all right? This is bit value 1, and this is 255. Bit value 1 on the third octet, this makes it a 237. So 172.20.237. And this is 255. So I just did that just to see everything, but this IP address belongs to the 236 network. That's what I came up with. What did you guys come up with? What did you guys come up with? We're gonna reveal the answer pretty soon here. You guys got an answer? All right, let's find out. Let's see if I was right or wrong. 236.0. 236.0. What did I do? Again, once I drew the line, I knew I incremented by two. I wasn't about to start incrementing by two. 2, 4, 6, 8. I'm not going to do that. So that's a pretty high number, 236. Okay. So what I do is you can do two things. You can multiply or you can divide. I divided. Two goes into two ones. All right. Then two goes into three ones as well. Leaves one as a remainder. Bring down the six. 8 times 2 is 16. Done. So 118. Two goes into 236, 118 times. Perfect. So 236.0 is my network. And then I just do my normal procedure, right? My increment of 1 in the third octet to 237. That gives me the broadcast. And then 15 or 255 plus 0 is 255. And then whatever's in between. But I didn't need all that. All I needed to know was the network. I just wanted to make sure, right? Do a little bit more. And then 236.0 is the answer. So subnetting is not difficult. It's not difficult. The way that they do it, if you're great in math and you know how to do all those high order, low order bit, inverting and ending, all that stuff, and you know how to do that, and you already got it down pat that way, and you can do it under 30 seconds, then that's fine. I don't care. As long as you come up with the right answer every time. This right here, there's really very basic math. You can, after a while, you can just look at the IP address and know what's going on. All right. So that's subnetting. Subnetting is pretty easy. All right. Let's do VLSM. Who can tell me what VLSM is? What's VLSM? Come on. This is a webinar for people to answer questions. Why do we have VLSM? Oh, let me put this big here. Boom. What is VL, not MS, but VLSM? What's VLSM? Variable length subnet masking. Nobody's going to tell me anything. Everybody's mute. Breaking a larger network down into small networks. Yes. All right. You're taking this huge network and you're breaking it down, okay, into smaller networks. Essentially, that's what it is. VLSM came around because they knew that when they were doing, and this is synonymous with, not that, classless routing, right? You're using CIDR notation because you got to move the line back and forth to meet the needs. The way that I do it, there's a million ways. You can go online and you can see a million ways to do VLSM. The way that I do it you will waste the least amount of IP addresses. You'll never be wrong. Okay? Ever be wrong. So let me set this up for you. Okay? So let's do right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the last two octets. This is the, I'll put it up here. This is the third octet, and this is the fourth octet. Okay? The first two we're not gonna mess with. So how many nodes do we need? All right. Nodes, let's start with 2,000 nodes. Let's start higher. Let's start with 4,200 nodes. Then we'll go down to 1,700 nodes. Then we'll go down to 500 nodes. And then we'll go down to 30. Let's not do that many. We don't have that much time. All right, so what do I need to get? I need to know first the network ID. I need to know the range. I need to know, let's get some space here. The broadcast. And I need to know the CIDR. All right. So what do you do? It's an order, isn't it? You start from largest and you go to lowest. Start from largest and you go to lowest. Okay. 4,200 nodes. Well, first and foremost, your starting point. What is your starting point? Whatever they give you. 172.16.0.0. That is your starting point. Okay? 172.16.0.0. That's where you're starting from. All right, so I need 4,200 nodes. Well, if you count for host, and you start by two and double as you go, this is 256, 512, 1024, 2048, 4096. Not enough. 8192. All right, 4096, is that enough? You got 4,200, you got to go there. All right, so the next thing I do is find my broadcast. This doesn't change. So now I get, what is this bit value right here? What is that bit value? That bit value is 32. This is 31, right? If I add all these together, it's 31. 31 plus 0, 31. Dot, if you add all these together, meaning the bit values, that's 255. Plus 0, 255. What's the CIDR? Oh, you got 8 on in the first octet, 8 on in the second, that's 16, 17, 18, 19. Questions? Why did I draw a line? How did I get that number? Why is that the starting point? There's got to be some questions. Let me put in the range and I'll let you think meanwhile. So what's after 0.0, 0.1 through 31.254? Questions. We're good. Everybody's good to go. Outstanding. All right. So now, and this is important. Now we look at this number right here. We got to go off that number for the next starting point. What is after 31.255? 32.0. 172.16.32.0. Okay. How many IPs do we need? 1,700. Well, we know we count by two and double as we go that this is 256, 512, 1024, 2048. Good. We can draw a line right there. Let's verify. Maybe I did bad math. 256, 512, 1024, 2048. Can do 1024. It's not enough. All right. 2048. So I draw my line. Perfect. Let's find the broadcast. We know that's the network. Let's find the broadcast. What's the broadcast? Well, if you add, what is this bit value here? This is 1248. So that means that if the sum of these three is 7, 7 plus 32 is what? 39. Okay. What's all these? We did the third octet. Now we're doing the fourth octet. It's 255 plus 0, 255. What's in between? What's after 32.0? 32.1. What's before 39.255? 39.254. And what is the CIDR? How many more bits did we borrow? Two more, so it's 18. And if you count, 8 plus 8 is 16, 17, or I should say 21, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Sorry. 21. I'm going to pause here for a second. You guys think? But if you have questions, ask now. I'll forever hold your peace. All right, this is the concept of VLSM. All right, when you go take the test, scaring everybody with my face out there. When you go take the test, you need to know this concept. You need to be able to do this in your head or in a piece of paper. Okay? Because they're not going to ask you straightforward questions like this. I'm just teaching you the concept. They'll tell you something like this. It's in every book that's out there. If in order to waste the least number of IP addresses in a VLSM network, in order to reduce the waste of IP addresses, what subnet mask would you use for a point-to-point network? In order to reduce the number of IP addresses, that you don't waste any IP addresses, what mask would you use on a point-to-point network? What would you use? That's how they're gonna look for it. Well, on a point-to-point network, you only need two IPs. So what mask? And I know some of you are saying, well, I use one. It's no. Started that /31. And that IP number, throw that out the window. Especially for the test. Throw that out the window. Okay? It's a CIDR 30. That gives you two IP addresses. You need to know this. This is how they're going to ask you that. Okay? But you would know that if you look up here. Right? I got my little bit values right here, right? 2, 4. Minus 2 is 2. And if you count, if the line would be here, that would be a 30. That would be a 30. That's why these little things you need to put when you go take your test so you can get things done quickly. Let's keep going. Let's knock this out. All right, so now the next we got is 500. Well, we look at this here. What's after that? What's after 39.255? All right, cool. We need 500. Well, we know this is 256. This is 512. We know the line is right there. All right? Cool beans. That's where the line's at. Let's find the broadcast. Always find the network ID and then go for the broadcast, please. Then you can find out what's in between. 172.16.40. Then you take, we're still here in the third octet. This is bit value 1. Bit value 1 plus the third in the third octet plus 40 in the third octet. That's 41. And then the last octet, you already know that's 255. It's the sum of all these added to this 0. That gives you that. What's after 40.0? 40.1. What's before 41.255? 41.254. Right? So what CIDR do we have? Well, we got to add two more. We borrowed two more bits, right? To that 21, that makes it 23. And if you look at it, 8 plus 8, that's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay? Very good, Mr. Claude. Very good, very good, very good. Claude's on point. All right. So now we got one more, VLSM. Right, let's bring this up here. All right. So now, what's after 41.255? Is 42.0. We need 30 IPs. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. 9. On its 2 is 30. All right, perfect. So we're now in the fourth octave, so we could no longer touch this. All right, so what's the broadcast? 172.16.42. You add this, it's 31. Because this is 32, right? 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. The bit values. One less that 32 is the sum of these numbers, which is 31 on the last octet, plus this 0 is 31. What's in between? 42.1 through 42.30. What's the CIDR notation? Well, this is 23, right? Over here, so that's 24, 25, 26, 27. We added 4 more bits to that 23. This is VLSM. Very good, Claude. Very good. 27. That's it. This is easy, but this comes with practice. You guys are in the field. You're not doing this on a daily basis. You're using calculators, but now you got to go take your Network Plus. You got to go take your CCNA. You got to go take your CCMP. I just renewed my CCMP April 26th. Okay. So you need to know this. Okay. You need to know it. And they're not going to be, when you get to the higher level certifications, they're not going to break it down for you. They're not going to give you they'll give you a mask. Okay. It may be insider notation, but they may just give you the last octet. Okay. And that's it. You got to figure out what networks to advertise at that point. So you need to know this. You need to know this. I can't say it enough. You need to know this. They're not gonna give it to you broken down at all. You need to know this. And know that in your CCNA, your Network Plus, your CCNA, and your CCMP, there is hands-on. There is hands-on, okay? And when it comes to the CCMP, yeah, you have summarization that you need to know. All right, you need to know that. And that's the last thing we're going to do here, summarization, all right? Which is the opposite of VLSM. There's rules, and like it to VLSM. In VLSM, there's rules. You want to start with 0, okay? You always want to start with the 0 network. You never want to start with anything less than that if you're doing it from scratch, okay? But the concept is that you start from the next available IP address. You start whatever they give you, and then when you get to the broadcast, you look at that, and then you start whatever's next after that. So you don't waste any IP addresses. The whole point of variable length subnet masking is that you don't waste IP addresses. And just, I got a question for you guys. If you're using VLSM, which is equal to classless routing, which routing protocol supports classless routing? Which routing protocol supports classless routing? Oh, okay. I need an answer. Which routing protocol supports classless routing, VLSM, that your CIDR is different on every segment? Which RIP? Claude, which RIP? If you say RIP version 1, you're right. RIP version 2, OSPF, V2 and V3, obviously, but we're not talking about IPv6. RIP version 2 supports classless. OSPF supports classless, and EIGRP supports classless. RIP version 1 doesn't support, right? Yeah. RIP version 1 doesn't support it. IGRP doesn't support it. But OSPF, I think, always supported it. BGP supports it. Yes, BGP supports it, most definitely. ISIS supports it, even though ISIS doesn't really care about IP addressing, but yeah. All right. So the routing protocols that we use today do support classless routing. So we don't have to be concerned about it. Right. But for whatever reason, people are still teaching RIP version one. I don't know. Okay. But no, we EIGRP. All right. We have EIGRP, EIGRP for IPv6, RIP version 2, RIPNG, and we have OSPF version 2 and OSPF version 3. All those support classless routing. Okay. All right. So let's talk about route summarization. Route summarization. All right. So route summarization, what are you doing? First of all, rules. Rules. Should start with an even network. Should be an even number of networks. Should be in, oh, you're not even seeing this. That's funny. Should be in contiguous order, meaning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so let's do an example. So you got 192.168.1.0, 192.168.2.0, 192.168.3.0. So we're not following the rules. This is not an even network. It's not an even number of networks. Okay, it is in contiguous order, but it's not the other two rules. All right, so how do I do this? Very simple. 128.64.32.16.8.4.2.1. All right, I turn the interesting octet, which is this guy, because remember, this is a default. This is by default outside of 24. I'm looking for the new. I'm looking for the summary mask. Okay, EIGRP. That's very good there. Very good, very good. I have a lag here. That's why I'm sorry. I'm getting the answers late. Apologize. All right. So now what I do is I take that third octet and I'm going to go ahead and put it in binary. 0, 0, got a twitch. 1. I'm just going to copy paste. Make things go quicker. All right, so 2 means this is on, this is off, and 3 means this is on. Perfect. So we got this. Easy, right? So I go from left to right. What am I looking for? I'm looking at each column. I'm looking at each column, and I'm saying, okay, these are all zeros. We're good, right? If they're all zeros or all ones, we're good. Leave it alone. All zeros, all zeros, all zeros, all zeros. Boom, I run into a column. Column 2 that says zeros and ones. Those are, now we have a combination of zeros and ones. That's not good. So we draw our line there. So what's our new mask? Okay, we had a 24, right? This is a default class C. We had a 24, okay, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So I'm in the third network. I apologize. I'm in the third network. I'm going crazy. So we got 8 bits on, 8 bits on. That's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. That's our new mask. When you're summarizing the prefix length, the subnet mask, the CIDR gets smaller and gives you more host, right? So, okay. So we got CIDR 22. So what does that mean? Okay, so what's now the summary address? Good question. All right, so we do our normal routine. Okay, we start, what's on here? It's zero, right? We start with 192.168. And you look at this side right here. Take a look at left of the line on the third octet here. This is the third octet. It's zero, so that's zero. Okay, and the fourth octet, obviously it's zero, somewhere out here, okay? All right, so we got that one. That's our network ID. What's our broadcast? Let's put it there. Let's put network ID. We'll calculate it. Well, let's calculate it now. Let me calculate it. Let me just finish that. That's our network ID. What's our broadcast? I just put broad. Okay. So it's 192.168. Well, we do the same thing. What's 2 plus 1? 3. 3 on the third to this 0, that's 3. Okay. And then we have the fourth octave, which is all off. We add those. That's 255 plus the 0 is 255. Do we not see a problem here? Don't worry about the range. Do we not see a problem here? We started with 1, 2, and 3. We ended up with 3, but we just inherited 0. We didn't follow the rules. So 0 crept in on us. Okay? That's why we follow the rules. But when you take the test, the rules go out the window. So your summary address would be 192.168.0.0 with a CIDR 22, which is 255.255. Wow, 252.0. Okay, that would be your summary address that you would use. So when you get asked a question when it comes to route summarization, it will either be for you to calculate the summary address, or they give you the summary address and you need to figure out what networks fall in that summary address. It's either or. So knowing this is important. Let's do one more example. And I want you guys to have questions. This needs to be a question answer thing, okay? We're going to do a lab afterwards and see if you guys know what to put. Okay, we'll do one more here for summarization. We'll follow the rules, shall we? We'll do it. We'll do high numbers. Do we? Yeah, why not? 192.168.101.0, 192.168.102.0, and 192.168.103.0. All right, cool. So we know that by default, that is a CIDR 24. We need the new mask. We don't know what it is yet. Okay, let's put a question mark there. Bring this up. You guys can see it. All right. Let's set this up, ready to work it out. 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. Awesome. So let's turn the third octet, which is the interesting octet. Let's turn that into binary. Binary. Let's do it. 0, 64, and 32, that is 96. 0, 0, that is 100. 0, 0. Let's copy paste. Make things go a lot quicker. Okay, so this is 100, 101. Let's turn that on. 102, 103. Awesome. We got it. All right, so now let's go from left to right. All zeros, good to go. Leave it alone. All ones, leave it alone. All ones, leave it alone. All zeros, all ones. Again, you come to this column. We draw the line. Draw the line. It's going to be the same thing. It's going to be a, what? That's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Sorry, I forget. 22. It's going to be the same thing. All right. So now we do 192.168. But what's different now? Before, everything was off. Now we got things that are on. Right? So what's on all the way down? The 64, the 32, and the 4. So that makes it what? 100. Fourth octet, it's out there somewhere in outer space. It's all zero. Here, this is your summary address. I'll just write that right now. Okay? That is your summary address. But let's work it out. Net ID. Broadcast. Okay? Forget about the range. So we got 192.168. What's on? 100. Okay. Dot zero. Well, we have a 100.0. We're good. We're not, nothing crept in there. All right, let's calculate it. 2 plus 1 is 3 on the third octet, plus 100 on the third octet is 192.168.103. And 255 on the fourth octet is 0, 255. There you go. It works perfectly. Even number of networks, contiguous, we're following the rules. Awesome. Everything works out. We got no extra IP addresses that come in, no extra networks. That's a good thing. Now, when you go take your test, it may not be that way. They'll give you, let's say, a routing table to look at. And then there'll be some, let's say, increments by 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. You have these networks, and they tell you summarize these networks. Follow the formula. Follow the rule. Let me put my face a little bit smaller. Okay. Follow that method right there. I'm telling you, this is the quickest. This is the easiest. This is the one you waste the least of anything. This is the best way to do things, is to do it that way. You can never go wrong. And in the CCNA, from what I remember, those tests way back then, you're either getting asked, you're given a summary address, and you got to come up with the networks, or you're given the networks, you're going to come up with a summary address. It's either or. It's either or. Okay? Are we okay with this? I need feedback. I need you guys to talk to me. All right? We okay? Oh, it's 9:35. We started at 8:30. I'm sorry. I always go over. I apologize. Well, before I let you go, that's, you know, we went over subnetting, we went over VLSM, and we went over route summarization. Okay? Just so you know, right? I already told you that I renewed my CCNP on April 26th. I got the encore. Okay? And I have a CCNP bootcamp starting this Saturday, May 6th. It's going to go on for 12 weeks. It's going to be 96 hours, all right? And one of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what I did to study for this encore test, okay? I'm going to show you what I did, all right? We're going to go over everything. Understanding this is key in the real world when you are told to take a larger network, break it up into a small network. That will be their own ambulance. Thank you, Mr. Claude. Thank you so much, okay? So, yes, definitely you need to know this. You need to know this for everything, for the CCNA, for the CCNP, for the Network Plus, any networking certification, you need to know this. This is just fundamentals, all right? So if you're ready for the CCNP, and I just passed in April 26th, the new encore, okay? Because, again, I had to renew. I'm sorry. I let things go. I was teaching. I was doing a whole bunch of things. I let everything go, so I had to renew it. All right. So I'm going to give you all the things that I did to get that test. All right. We're going to cover from cover to cover. Isn't that funny? We're going to cover from cover to cover. All right. Everything that you're going to need to know. We'll be doing all sorts of labs. I've repeated myself, I don't know how many times. All sorts of labs. Starting on Saturday, you're gonna have an assessment lab. Sunday, we'll probably be already in chapter 4 doing MST. Okay? We will be doing labs. We will be going over concepts. We will be knowing how to do this. Conditional matching, the weird wildcard masks. I'll show you how to break it down, so you can find out the answers. BGP, you know that's going to be something I'm going to highlight. All right? And, of course, the analyzing, we're going to do HSRP, VRP, GOBP, route summarization that we just did right now. We're going to do IP routes. We're going to do VACLs, ACLs, all right? All that good stuff, EEMs, SPAN, RSPAN. All right, we'll be doing all that stuff. Okay, so know that I'm going to give you everything that I did to pass that test. All right, especially the labs. And we will be using Eve NG. I have the viral images for Eve NG. So we'll be using that. So we'll be learning terms, we'll be learning configurations, and we'll be troubleshooting. So if you're ready, May 6th, Saturday, 3 to 7, with me for 12 weeks, 96 hours, we'll be doing that boot camp. Just go to globed.net, sign up, and I'll see you guys there. We'll be doing IPv4. Oh, yeah. We'll be doing IPv6 on all the routing protocols, to include ISIS. Everything will be touched. Everything will be covered. You don't have a choice. You need to know it, not only for your certification, but for what you're doing right now in the real world. You need to know it. Things are changing. They're changing quickly. And we need engineers out there that know everything. Not only the latest and greatest, which we'll talk about that as well, JSON and Puppet and Chef, okay? And the controllers and all that good stuff. We'll talk about it, okay? And we'll understand it, and we'll look at the formats, and we'll do all that. But you need to understand the core of routing and switching. You have to. And I will teach you ISIS. You don't have a choice in that. Thank you very much, Mr. Barauza. Thank you very much. Well, with this, I guess I'll let you guys go. I kept you a little bit over an hour. I do apologize. Thank you for joining me this evening. All right. And I hope to do this again very soon. If not, I will see everyone on May 6th at the CCMP Bootcamp. You guys be safe. Stay strong. Keep practicing. Take care.